We're gonna sip this before he get here because I'm a little nervous, like I keep saying. What's up, everybody, and welcome back to my channel. It's Jugray here. I am about to, when y'all see the robe, I'm about to do a get ready with me. And as y'all can tell by the title, we're about to do a get ready with me. And so, y'all, you're finally going on a little date. I haven't been on a date in a minute with my boyfriend, but we just have not been doing much, so we're finally doing something. I've been sick pretty much this whole break and we just haven't been able to get it together to go, so we're finally going somewhere. So I'm about to do my makeup and talk about my ins and outs for 2024. I know it's late, it's already like the end of January, but I still wanted to get this video out because I really wanted to film this. And I am also having my first little sip of something, a little drinky drink, because I haven't been drinking. I just want to be loose for my date. Like, I don't know why I'm nervous. Like, it's my boyfriend, but yeah, I'm nervous. So I'm excited and nervous. But I'm about to prime my face twice. So I'm gonna use this e.l.f. glow serum primer. I like this primer because it has like a little glitter and glow in it. So I'm also gonna try to like really not mess up my baby hair and have to do my damn edges again. Sure. Spin it all over my face. I'm also letting my little light charge, so my lighting will definitely improve as the video goes on. I also got my eyebrows done maybe like a week ago. And they did my eyebrows way too thin and also like not how my eyebrows usually look. They're like round. Who has round eyebrows? Maybe some people do. It probably fit them, but I don't. I'm a square girl. So I need to definitely do my eyebrows. Okay, and now I'm gonna go in with my other primer. This is the e.l.f. Grip Primer. I love this primer. I never realized like how much of a difference primer makes. Like, I really see a difference in my makeup. And I also got new makeup products, y'all, so I'm so excited to like be doing my makeup and using my new products. I'm not putting on lashes. I'm trying to give my lashes jump scare, and the nails, disregard the nails. I'm gonna have to redo my edges because I just messed them up. We're letting our nails breathe for a few days before we do our Valentine's set. And then I'm also gonna let my lashes breathe until then. I've been putting my lash serum on to get my lashes to grow, so yeah. I'm gonna put a little more primer on. My face real sticky. So we're gonna start with the positives, y'all. We are gonna start with our ins for 2024. Okay, so my very first in for 2024, let's take a sip. First of all, cheers. Grab your drink because it's probably gonna be a long one. This is a really sweet Moscato. I was using this wine to cook and I just saw it in my refrigerator and I was like, let's use it. Let's drink. My first in for 2024 is prioritizing myself. That means prioritizing my health. Saying no when I don't want to drink, even though I just took a little sip. Saying no when I don't feel like drinking. Saying no to bad food. I haven't eaten fast food. I've been doing so good, y'all. I have not eaten any fast food. What's he doing, my eyebrows? I have a mirror here, viewfinder, and a mirror behind y'all. If y'all see me looking in a whole bunch of different directions. So yeah, y'all, I have not been eating any fast food. I have been doing a lot of cooking, and if I do eat out, it's I try to eat like real whole food. So I had kava, I'm trying to think of all that I've had since I haven't been eating fast food. I really think that's it, because I've been eating, well, I had Chipotle. Is Chipotle fast food? I don't know. I'm prioritizing also like when I say prioritizing myself, like putting what I want to do first, and sometimes I just don't be wanting to do stuff. And me and my cousin was literally just talking about this. Like, I do be wanting to do things, but it takes a lot of my energy. And so I can't commit to something. I gotta like really think about it. Cause if I commit in the moment, like off of impulse, I'm like so excited. And then I'll have like a really tiring, draining week. And then I'm like, I can't do it. Like, I just don't have the capacity. I don't have the energy. So you see how like all of this is missing from my eyebrows, y'all? I gotta fill all this in. I never have to fill in my eyebrows. She messed me up. I feel like if somebody messes up your eyebrow, like, you can never trust them again. Cause like, you hating on me. Like, you're low key hating. You praying on my downfall. Prioritizing working out. Sometimes I'll like, because I know I don't really feel like working out, I'll like make up an excuse like, oh, I have to go do something, or I have to work a little later, or I don't know, I have to go do something so I can't work out. No, I'm prioritizing myself and I'm gonna work out. And then I'll get to the other stuff. Cause I use that as an excuse to not work out, like I said. So I'm not gonna do that no more either. We are not putting other people's needs and wants before our own. Something else I really want to do in 2024, y'all, is take a solo trip. I really want to. I did it once and I really want to do it again. I really want to put like my fear aside and go on a solo, like not even a trip, like a full-on vacation. I want to do like a vacay away. And I always see Aaliyah Faith do this. I see my friend Shanta did this and I'm like, damn, y'all are brave. Like, I really want to do this. Okay. Now I'm about to go in with some color corrector. I have been using different color correctors, like playing around. So I'm gonna use this kind of like that. Do I have, no, I don't have any really like dark, I'm kind of right here, a dark spot. And then I mix this orange color corrector, it's just the Pro Concealer. This orange one with the Tarte Chic Tape Concealer. This is, I don't know if y'all could tell the color. It's like a peach. So I just kind of mix these two to color correct. And to just kind of brighten up, because I kind of want like this area to be a little bright too. Here, because that, I got like a little scar right there that I want to hide. I look crazy. And then I go in with my, I just got these beauty blenders too. This is also new. My color corrector, the peach one, is new. Okay, our next in for 2024 is reading for pleasure. So pretty much all of last year, I just was so freaking busy going back to school and like reading for work, like reading things that had to do with education, or like my 18 hours that I was getting. And it was just like overload. Like, it was way too much. And so now I'm gonna start reading things that like I really enjoy. And I'm currently reading a book, it's called Think Like a Monk. And it's about, not necessarily manifesting, but it's about, well, I guess it is about manifesting. It's about conquering like peace. Peace within yourself, peace within your mind, peace within things that don't go your way, or like, you know, don't work out how you expected them to. And I'm currently on chapter 5. I think they have 11 chapters and I'm on chapter 5 right now. Okay, so we look a little crazy. We look a tad bit crazy, but that is okay. We are going to set that. I have a tiny bit of my Laura Mercier translucent powder. I have like literally a tiny bit. So I'm trying to be like sparing with it. Okay. I know I look so crazy. My next in is manifesting more. We are about to use the Hourglass concealer. I got this brand new. This is in the color Beach. So I'm excited to try those. I'm gonna do a lot because the way I want to do my makeup, it's gonna be a little different. I'm gonna put some here. And then I want a little bit like here. I'm gonna kind of let that sit. And then I'm gonna go in with my foundation. This is my Huda Beauty Foundation. Kind of put this in other areas. And we're just gonna like mix it all in. Blend it all together. Manifesting more. I have got to get back on my manifesting-ish, y'all. Like, I have legit, like, been so sleep on my manifesting, and I have got to get back to it. Last year, I don't feel like there was much that I manifested, besides, obviously, my new career. And at the very end of 2023, I manifested my dream car, y'all. I got into my dream car, which is the Range Rover. And I'm so excited. Like, that just like lit me up that I manifested my dream car. And it reminded me of like what I'm capable of. It reminded me like, okay, you really can manifest this shit. Like, you can do this. You put your mind to something and you really could do it. And so there's just so many more things that I want to manifest. And so I want to get back to that. And I really want to put like so much of my energy. And it takes work. Like, manifesting is not something that you can just say, oh, I want a Range Rover and leave it at that. No. Like, I put it on my vision board in November, y'all. I started like appraising my car, what my Lexus was worth. I started to like play around with numbers and search. I started to like pick out the specs, like how I wanted my Range Rover to look. And that's how you manifest. Like, you have to put in the work. You can't just say you want to manifest something and not put in the energy behind it. And so now that I know I'm capable of doing that, I want to manifest a vacation, like for me and my man too, like not just me. I do want to go on a solo trip, but I want to manifest like a getaway trip. Our 1 year anniversary is going to be coming up. But I want us to be able to like afford it and not think twice about it. You know what I mean? Like, I don't want to have to stress when I get back home. Like, damn, I just spent $2,000-$3,000 out the country. No, I want to go to where I get like the perfect deal, like perfect straight flights. I know that's kind of like crazy to get straight flights. But yeah, I want to manifest that. I want to manifest like having deeper connections and relationships with people, like growing closer to people in my life. There's just so many things that I want to manifest, and I know it takes work. Like, it's just not something that you can just say you want to do and just wish for it. You have to put in the energy behind it. And so how does that look? Like, I literally every single day I do some type of manifestation technique or work. Like, I'll write down certain things. The other night I did this technique. It was called 10-10-10, where you write down 10 things that you want to, like your desires. Like 10 things you want, you write down 10 things you're grateful for, and then you write down 10 things. Whoa, what's just the other one? You write down 10, oh my God, what is the other one? 10 things you want, 10 things you're grateful for. I don't remember. Whatever, but I've been doing manifestation techniques. Number 4 is growing spiritually. I want to get like so deep on a spiritual level, like so close to God, like reestablish my faith. I feel like I haven't lost my faith, but when it comes to like church and things like that, like I guess the actual like format is a weird word to say. Just I guess like how I practice, and I know there's no wrong way to practice faith, but I definitely want to start physically going to church. I currently just like watch church online. I'm putting more concealer because I really want that bright under eye. I just watch church online, and it's like, that's okay, but how effective is it? Like, I really want to experience it in person and experience just the nature of like like the energy, if that makes sense. Like the energy in the room, like how everyone is just, because watching it on TV, like everybody just looks so like connected spiritually. I don't know if that makes sense what I'm trying to say, but I just really want to experience that type of energy. And before the pandemic, I was going to see John Gray at Joel's church. I was going to see him like religiously, but I definitely want to get back to that as well. Physically going to church and like bringing God into my manifestations, because I told y'all a million times, like, what I believe God is the universe, and God gives me the capability to manifest. Like, he is him. So I just want to get back to that. Last but not least for my ends is pouring into myself. And that's different from prioritizing, because what I mean by pouring into myself is like literally pouring into my looks, pouring into my, yeah, really just my looks. And I know that might sound vain, but like I want to elevate how I look, meaning I want to really like transform my body. I have such a natural like curvy body, and I feel like I haven't done it justice. Like, I've abandoned my body, and that's not good at all. It's like I really have a temple, and I just like, girl, people pay to have a body like me. Like, they get BBLs and shit, and it's like you have it naturally and you don't even take care of it. And not just like physical, my body, but like growing my lash, which is so physical, but growing my lashes, getting my hair extremely, extremely healthy, growing my hair really, really long. I really want to grow my hair back to how long it used to be. Like in 2018, my hair was so long, and I want to get back to that. I want to really, y'all know this is a goal of mine because I keep talking about it. I really want to learn how to do my makeup. Like, I want to be a makeup guru, not to like do makeup on other people or like make a profit from it, but like if I have somewhere to go, like a ball or like shit, my wedding or some shit, like I want to be able to do my makeup. Which, as of right now, our base is looking really good. Okay, so I'm about to just set what I did, and then we're gonna bake. So I hope that makes sense, like everything I just explained, because that is all, baby, my ends. And they're all positive. It's just things that I want to do for myself to be like the best version of myself, if that makes sense. I want to become like beautiful inside and out. I want to be just a really like phenomenal person. And I am getting older now, so I'm just thinking like, how would people describe me? Like, you know, I think about that. How are people gonna describe me? I want people to describe me as, oh, like she was a beast. Like she was dope. So yeah. Okay, so something new that we got is our one size pink powder. I am so excited for this, y'all. So freaking excited for this. I'm just such a pink girly now, and I never thought I'd see the day. But your girl is like loving pink. And I've been using this for not long, maybe like 5 days. I've been using this and I absolutely love it. And I definitely see a difference in my makeup. Like, it is so pretty. It is so freaking pretty. It just like really brightens your eye. And that's what I've been trying to achieve for the longest. It's like a really bright under eye. And I feel like, girl, I'm getting it. I love this, the pink one size powder. Okay, I guess we gotta talk about the negative now. Which, to be honest, it's not even really negative. So whatever. But number one that got to get the up out of here is caring what people think about me. Honestly, recently, truly, honestly, I have been really struggling. Like, I always say, like, I don't care what people think about me, but recently I have been struggling. I'm just putting some bronzer on my eyelid so we don't look like a vampire and look pale. At work, for sure, it's been happening a lot. And like, I've really been struggling at work, and I've fallen like victim to caring what people think about me, who absolutely have nothing to do with my life. And I've been caring about, I've been caring about like how I am perceived by other people who once again have absolutely nothing to do with my life. I'm caring about like my reputation, like what people are saying about me. And it's like, girl, who gives a flying f-? Because at the end of the day, they don't pay your bills. They don't really know you. So like they're basing their perception off non-factual things. Like they don't know you. So how can they even, you know, fix their lips to say whatever? Because they don't know you. And so I'm working on that. Like I was struggling with that. I'm just contouring my nose a little bit. And I'm not sure why I just did that. I really don't know why I did that. Because it looks a little harsh. It looks a little too much that I just contoured my nose. I don't even need to contour my nose. Girl, what are you doing? What are you doing? I'm going to use the same bronzer on my cheeks. Yeah, I'm going to have to redo my baby hair. Point of the matter is, I don't give up what people think. And guess what? You thought I was tatted now? Oh, baby, I'm really about to get tatted. Your girl is a college professor. I have achieved what I needed to achieve. And, baby, I am about to go ham. I look crazy right now. Okay, another one. And y'all know y'all gonna put me on this one because it's for y'all. I am going to not... Okay, I'm going to not vlog because I'm embarrassed or scared because I'm in public or something like that. I'm gonna stop that. Because I low-key not be embarrassed. I guess it goes back to like what people think of me. Like a lot of people at work found my channel. The kids for sure found my channel, but like the adults too. And I be thinking about that like, oh my God, like I can't put this in my video because like people from work, I don't care. Like I had a YouTube channel before I became an educator and it is what it is. Like if y'all watching, y'all watching, whatever. I don't care no more. So I'm not about to do that because guess what? YouTube pays me and all I'm doing is like holding myself back and hindering myself. You know what I mean? Like I'm stopping myself from growing because I'm scared to vlog or I'm scared to put information. Like girl, whatever. Vlog. Okay, this next one that gotta go in 2024 and it's something like I really, really struggle with. And not that I'm embarrassed to say, oh, it's the truth, but I overthink and overanalyze so much. And that is something that really has to go. Like, I cannot keep doing that to myself because I legit will stress myself out overthinking and overanalyzing and picturing things that aren't even factual. Like, really just driving myself crazy because of a possibility, maybe, never know. Like, girl, whatever. And I learned this in therapy. Facts over fear. So this is new. I got a Morphe mascara. And I'm using this. It's focusing on me and not the mascara. But this is a Morphe mascara. I got a piece of hair or lint, something on me. I'm using this since we're not doing our lashes. So yeah. I'm gonna stop overthinking and using what I learned in therapy about facts over fear and like really sit down with myself and like, girl, talk to myself and be like, but is this fact? You're saying this right now because you're scared. That's also in the book that I'm reading, The Think Like a Monk. It talks about like analyzing fears. Like we do certain things out of fear and it's like, girl, chill out. These are your fears. These aren't facts. So I definitely got to work on that. And that's something like I'm struggling with in my relationship because I was in a very, you know, bad relationship and I still like hold on to certain things. Like I'm triggered by certain things and it's like, girl, this is not the same person. This is not the same situation at all. Like remotely the same situation. What are the facts? So I have to keep telling myself that because I'm like my own worst enemy, if that makes sense. Okay, this mascara is like, whoa. I haven't worn my real lashes and mascara in so long. Like, okay. Your girl got lashes. Hey. I'm gonna bring back in some blush because I feel like I don't look proportioned. I need some more. I'm looking for the blushes in my life. I got new brushes too. So I'm gonna use the blush brush that I just got. Where is it? This one. It's a Real Techniques brush. And I mix these, the Juvia's palettes. I just mix them. Tap. Just putting, oh yeah, just pretty. My next thing, again, they're not negatives at all. It's just things that I need to be doing. Cause girl, everything that I need to be doing, I haven't been. I always like to put a little blush on my nose. Like so. Okay, the next thing is doing things that I don't want to do. So I will do things sometimes that I don't want to do. I mean, I will not do things that I don't want to do, and it ends up like hurting me in the long run. Meaning, if I go out at night and I come back home and I sleep in the next day because I don't feel like going to work out, I can't do that. Like, you need to get up and you need to go work out. Like, you need to get your together. So doing things that I don't want to do, even though I know like they're good for me. Does that make sense? Doing things because I just don't feel like it. Like, for instance, I came home today and I did not want to fold my laundry. Like, I just didn't feel like it. I just really wanted to start getting cute. And I sat down for a second, literally a second, like 5 minutes. And then I was like, okay, now get up and go do what you need to do. Go do your laundry. Because I will let laundry sit and sit and sit. Like, girl, stop being lazy. Get up. We're pretty much almost done our makeup. We have a really good base. I'm gonna let that sit and line my lips. Y'all know Drew. Can y'all guess? What am I lining my lips with? Can y'all guess? Cork. Cork by MAC. We absolutely have to stop procrastinating and stop putting things off. That's what it is. That's the word. I put things off because I don't feel like it. Or like cooking because I don't feel like cooking today. And just pick up something on the way home, which would probably be fast food, right? Mm-mm. No, ma'am. We're not doing that. You're gonna get home and you're gonna cook. Even though you don't feel like it. We're going to do things that we don't feel like doing because we're an adult. We're grown. We gotta handle our responsibilities. And things like sometimes, like, I don't feel like going to get grocery or something. Like, I just wanna be lazy. Mm-mm. Last but not least, I don't know why I just licked my lips. I need to wipe that. Last but not least, y'all, our last one was getting out in 2024. We are going to not be lazy. And it kind of goes with number four, like not doing things that I don't want to do. Sometimes I just don't be feeling like editing an hour vlog and then it'll come out 2 weeks later. And it's like, why are you doing that to yourself? Stop being lazy. Handle your business. Handle the things you need to be doing. Okay, just got this. This is new. I got the e.l.f. Oh, come on now. The e.l.f. lip oil in the color. What's this color? This is Honey Talks is the color. I am absolutely obsessed. I see what the hype is about lip oil. Because for the longest, I couldn't get it. I'm like, isn't it just lip gloss? It's so pretty. It is so pretty. Oh my god. Oh my god. And y'all know I'm a matte girl. Like, I do not wear lip gloss. Nothing shiny. Oh my god, it's so pretty. It's so pretty. Oh my god, I love it. So pretty. Okay, we're gonna brush away our little bake we had going on. I definitely feel like this side is more pink, so I need to add a little more blush to this side. But overall, I like how my makeup looks. I just feel like we're gonna test it like as the night goes on. And I think I need a little more blush. I'm gonna just use the residue that's on the brush and put up here. Yeah, yeah. Oh, I love it. Okay, also our one size spray, I'm obsessed with this too. Like I see this crack, like I see. I understand at first, like, girl, why is this a little bitty can $34? I see. Your makeup ain't going nowhere. I saw somebody say, oh my God, I saw somebody say it's just hairspray in a can. And I low-key feel like it is because it's so strong. It is so strong. Ooh. But your makeup not going nowhere. I'm also putting a little bit of this on too. My Morphe. This is the oldie but goodie. I just feel like this leaves me like not too, I guess, dry and matte. Okay, I think her makeup is done. I'm about to go get dressed. I'm gonna fix my hair and do my edges again, and I'll be back. Okay, we are back. I love how my makeup turned out. I feel like a baby. I put on this little choker that has, it keeps flipping, which is so annoying. It has different colored hearts on it. I'm wearing silver. I'm wearing snakeskin boots, so I'm gonna put silver accessories on. My rings, ugh, the nails. I wish I had the nails did. We gonna let this slide. A pinky ring. A pinky ring. It's a little weird. Okay, this is like a midi ring, so we're gonna leave this like this. I love my makeup. And our scent is gonna be this YSL. I think this is Paris. This is YSL Mopedi, I believe. I think. I be trying to match my perfume, y'all, with my outfit. Ooh, smells so sweet and good. Fit in my hair. So, ooh, Lord. It's giving, like, silver. So, the black and the silver. Or I have my YSL, the Libre Intense. That's, like, that gives me gold in, like, fall. So, I try to match. I don't know if that makes sense, but I try to match the fragrances. And y'all can't really see my top, but it's, like, this low cut V. We're giving sexy. Okay, I absolutely love my makeup. Okay, and I'm putting a little bit more of this lip oil on because it's just so pretty. It has like a slight tint. I'm feeling myself. I am feeling myself. I look good. I hope my man think I look good. So I haven't even finished the wine, y'all. We're gonna sip this before he get here because I'm a little nervous, like I keep saying. Comment down below and let me know one in and one out that y'all are doing for 2024. I hope y'all enjoyed the makeup look and my new makeup products. I am really trying to get into my makeup bag and be a makeup girly. Be honest, do it look good? I feel like it look good. Do I look like a makeup girly? Okay, thank y'all so much for watching. Make sure you comment down below. Like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And I'll see y'all in the next one.